In the currency quadrant today, we got the euro up 33 basis points. That's up now 4 consecutive days and 4 consecutive weeks. Still short of the August 6 highs, though. We ended up getting a high today of 118.57.5 and a low of 117.88.5. Again, we're still short of those August 6 highs, but that 4 consecutive days in a row matches a solid streak of up weeks for the euro against the US dollar. Now, the Fed's balance sheet versus the ECB balance sheet is a big part of what's going on with the euro. The ECB balance sheet is actually growing, while the Fed very recently has been shrinking, not deliberately, but assets they've had have been going to their duration completion, and they haven't been replacing them. They haven't been as aggressive. Now, that says that the Fed has more bullets left over based on the promised amount of asset spending. They basically said they would do whatever they can, but the ECB is actually acting. Now, you might think that means more currency in circulation, and it does from the euro side of things, but it's a positive indicator to the EU economy, and that's why the euro is taking advantage of that. We've also got converging spreads between the 10-year note in the US and the Bund in Germany. That's also supporting the euro. Now, next week, there's some important data that could affect the euro. We've got the ECB minutes from the last meeting, along with the Fed minutes from the last meeting. We've got the flash PMI for both euro and Germany, and we've got EU consumer confidence, along with ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos, who's speaking next week. All of that could affect the direction of the euro short term.